Hello everyone! Here in this video, let's discuss the pharmacology of benzodiazepines. Benzodiazepines are well-known drugs, commonly known as benzos. These drugs act on the CNS, producing an inhibitory effect, hence, they are considered CNS depressants. As they produce sedation and reduce agitation, they are also called minor tranquilizers. So what are the actions of these benzodiazepines? These categories of drugs reduce anxiety and they also reduce irritability, which again reduces symptoms of anxiety. That's why these benzos are classified as anxiolytics. They also increase calmness in the patients, hence they are called sedatives, and they induce sleep, that's why they are called hypnotics. In addition, a few of these drugs can reduce neuronal excitability, thereby reducing the risk of convulsions. Hence, these drugs also act as anticonvulsants. But how can these drugs be identified? As we come across a wide number of drugs acting on the CNS, how can these benzodiazepines be identified or even differentiated from other drugs? Here these benzodiazepines can be recognized by two suffixes, one is azepam and the other is azolam. Now let's see how many of these listed drugs are really benzodiazepines. Here, diazepam has the suffix azepam, so it is a benzodiazepine. Similarly, clonazepam and nitrazepam are also benzodiazepines. Here triazolam has the suffix azolam, so it is also a benzodiazepine. Similarly, alprazolam is also a benzodiazepine. Clozapine is not a benzodiazepine because it lacks the suffixes azepam or azolam. This drug is an antipsychotic. Similarly, zolpidem is not a benzodiazepine but acts in the same way. So it is considered a non-benzodiazepine hypnotic. Finally, citalopram is an antidepressant. Nonetheless, we can find a few benzodiazepines with different suffixes. For instance, chlordiazepoxide is an earlier benzodiazepine that was developed with a different suffix. Similarly, clobazam is a 1,5-benzodiazepine with a different suffix. Finally, chlorazepate is a benzodiazepine with 3-carboxylic acid, so it exists as an anion. These are a few of the exceptions to the main suffix of benzodiazepines. Apart from these, all other benzodiazepines have either of the two suffixes, such as azepam or azolam, which makes them easy to identify. Now let's see the classification of benzodiazepines. Benzodiazepines mainly exist in two types of structures. The first one can be denoted by the primary suffix pam, whereas the second structure is denoted by the suffix lam. Here in the first structure, we can observe two nitrogens at the first and fourth positions, which is indicated by another suffix, -ase. So the entire suffix is azepam, and many benzodiazepines exist with this suffix. Diazepam is one of the examples. But in the second structure, one of the nitrogens is included in the fused ring system. It can be denoted by the term azo, so the entire suffix is azolam. Here, azo indicates it is a fused benzodiazepine. Alprazolam is one of the examples in this category. Benzodiazepines can be classified based on the duration of action. First, ultra-short-acting benzodiazepines mainly include midazolam and triazolam. These drugs have a duration of action of less than 6 hours. Short-acting drugs include lorazepam, oxazepam, and temazepam. These drugs show a duration of action of 12 to 24 hours. These drugs are easily remembered in this context because their first letters are LOT. Medium-acting drugs include alprazolam and nitrazepam, with a duration of action of approximately 24 hours. Finally, many of the benzodiazepines are long-acting. Drugs like diazepam, flurazepam, clonazepam, and chlordiazepoxide are long-acting benzodiazepines with durations of action ranging from 24 to 48 hours. Now let's focus on the mechanism of action of benzodiazepines. Within the CNS, a few of the inhibitory neurons express one of the receptors, GABA-A. This is an ionotropic receptor on which GABA acts to open the ion channel. This receptor is pentameric in nature, which means it is composed of 5 subunits. Based on the combination of subunits, various types of GABA receptors are expressed, but among them, this is one of the most widely expressed combinations, with two alpha subunits, two beta subunits, and one gamma subunit. This receptor allows the entry of chloride ions when it is activated. But under resting conditions, this channel is closed, and chloride ions cannot enter. To open these channels, GABA is required, which is released by neuronal transmission. Now that GABA has been released, it can act on GABA A receptors, particularly it binds between the alpha and beta subunits. This results in a conformational change, resulting in the opening of the chloride channel through which chloride ions can enter. This results in the hyperpolarization of the postsynaptic membrane, resulting in an inhibitory response. Now, benzodiazepines act in a similar way to enhance the action of GABA. Benzodiazepines can bind to a site in between alpha and gamma subunits that promotes the binding of GABA to the GABA A receptors, leading to the entry of a greater number of chloride ions and resulting in significant hyperpolarization. As a result, benzodiazepines reduce anxiety and irritability while also inducing sleep and providing sedation. They also reduce the tendency for neuronal excitation, resulting in a reduced induction of seizures. Benzodiazepines are well known under different brand names. Let's see a few of the most important among them. Diazepam is well known by its brand name, Valium. Alprazolam Xanax, clonazepam Clonopin, temazepam Restoril, triazolam Halcyon, lorazepam Ativan, flurazepam Dalmane, chlorazepate Tranxine, midazolam Verst, and chlordiazepoxide Librium. Pharmacokinetics of benzodiazepines. Benzodiazepines can be given in a variety of ways. They can be given by the oral route, the IV route, or the rectal route as suppositories. Few of the benzodiazepines, such as lorazepam and oxazepam, show poor oral absorption due to their polar nature. If we look at the metabolism, benzodiazepines mainly undergo two types of metabolic reactions. Let's take the example of diazepam. This is the structure of this drug. Now it can undergo endealkylation. Here we can see a methyl group is present on the first nitrogen. This methyl group is removed to give the metabolite nordiazepam, which is also called nordazepam. This is one of the long-acting active metabolites. In the next step, it undergoes 3-hydroxylation. This is the third position in the structure where a hydroxyl group is attached to make it polar and water-soluble. Now, nordiazepam is converted into oxazepam by this process. Finally, oxazepam can be conjugated with glucuronic acid, and this conjugate is excreted in the urine. Just like that, most of the benzodiazepines are metabolized by two reactions, such as endealkylation and 3-hydroxylation. Since nordiazepam is a long-acting active metabolite, those benzodiazepines that are converted into it are also long-acting. For instance, chlordiazepoxide is initially converted into damoxepam, which is then converted into nordiazepam. Likewise, prazepam and chlorazepate are also converted into nordiazepam, so they are long-acting. Contrarily, temazepam is not converted into nordiazepam, instead, it is metabolized into oxazepam. Consequently, it is a short-acting benzodiazepine. Side effects of benzodiazepines. Benzodiazepines mainly produce three important effects. They act on the CNS, resulting in CNS depression. They can also impair the memory and alter the functions of skeletal muscles, resulting in muscle paralysis. By causing a central depression, they can produce drowsiness, dizziness, sedation, and headaches. That's why alcohol should not be combined with benzodiazepines, as the former can also depress the CNS. So benzos, when taken with alcohol, may result in severe sedation and coma, hence, this combination should be avoided. The second important side effect is cognitive impairment. Benzos can produce anterograde amnesia, which impairs the memory of current events. This is especially noticeable in elderly people over the age of 60. Benzos can also induce a little confusion in elders, and they can also produce slurred speech. The third side effect is motor impairment. As we have seen earlier, benzodiazepines can depress the CNS, so they can produce delirium, an altered mental state resulting in reduced alertness and response. Concurrently, they can also produce muscle relaxation and motor incoordination. This may impair daytime activities, so caution should be taken while driving vehicles or working with machinery when using benzodiazepines. Benzos can produce other side effects such as fatigue, tiredness in patients, asthenia, a state where there is a lack of energy, vertigo, or reeling sensation, and tremor. All such side effects can be observed with benzos. Next, let's talk about the tolerance produced by benzodiazepines. Tolerance is a reduction in the pharmacological response when a particular drug is used frequently. Generally, benzodiazepines act on GABA-A receptors, resulting in the opening of chloride channels that produce an inhibitory response. If these receptors are not working properly or if they become desensitized, then tolerance will develop towards benzodiazepines. So with an enhanced dose and frequency of administration, GABA-A receptors are frequently activated, which may result in the desensitization or downregulation of some GABA-A receptors, leading to a reduced pharmacological response. Notably, tolerance to benzodiazepine anticonvulsant activity is more commonly observed. Then what about the dependence? Dependence is just like addiction to a drug. Even though benzos have less dependence than opioids, abruptly stopping the dose may result in withdrawal symptoms. When these drugs are used for more than 4 weeks, dependence becomes more apparent. In such conditions, the dose should be slowly tapered over the coming weeks to reduce withdrawal effects. Generally, withdrawal effects may be either physiological, resulting in a few symptoms, or psychological, resulting in a craving for the drug. Fortunately, benzos show fewer psychological symptoms, so withdrawal effects mainly include physiological symptoms, which are quite opposite to the actions of benzodiazepines. Benzos can cause anxiety, insomnia, and irritability during withdrawal. Appetite is also reduced, resulting in weight loss. The risk of convulsions may be increased, so benzos should not be stopped suddenly in patients with any history of seizures. Now let's see the clinical uses of benzodiazepines. Benzodiazepines can be used for the management of anxiety disorders such as generalized anxiety disorder, where anxiety exists for more than 4 months and is not associated with any known reason. Similarly, benzodiazepines can treat social anxiety disorder, where anxiety is generated by social interactions, and panic anxiety disorder, where anxiety is associated with panic symptoms such as sweating, tremor, and an increased heart rate. Similarly, a few of the benzos can be used as hypnotics in the treatment of insomnia. Even though these drugs reduce REM sleep, which may result in the daytime rebound effects that commonly observed with short-acting drugs, they increase total sleep quality and sleep time. Drugs like temazepam, clonazepam, sedatives, clozapam, and triazolam are generally used as hypnotics. Another important indication is for the management of epilepsy. Particularly, drugs like clonazepam, diazepam, lorazepam, and clobazam are indicated for this purpose. A few of the benzos can also be used as general anesthetics given via the IV route. Midazolam, diazepam, and lorazepam are indicated for this purpose. As benzodiazepines produce muscle relaxation, they are also indicated for the treatment of muscle spasms, and diazepam is one of the examples. As an off-label purpose, these drugs can also be used to reduce symptoms associated with alcohol withdrawal. Diazepam, chlordiazepoxide, and lorazepam can reduce the symptoms of alcohol withdrawal. That's it, folks. So that's all about the pharmacology of benzodiazepines. Thanks for watching. Let's meet with another interesting topic in our next video. Until then, goodbye, take care, and have a great day.